Welcome to EuroPCR 2019 in Paris. My name is Lars Søndergaard. I'm from Copenhagen in Denmark. I got the pleasure to be here with Francesco Maisano from Switzerland and Francesco Bedogni from Italy. And we're here today to talk about the Portico I study and particularly the new data coming out on stratifying patients into different surgical risk scores. Before we start, I'm going to ask you, Francesco Bedogni, to try to tell us about the main study on Portico I. So if you can please tell us about the study and the device which was used.
Portico I is the most important study when the portico valve started in 2013. It is a prospective registry controlled with the core lab echo. It's very controlled trial about the treatment of aortic stenosis in high-risk patients with the portico valve. And he enrolled around 1,000 patients, and the results are very good, comparable with that. We have the follow-up now at 1 year, and the results are good compared to the other devices, and with a mortality rate of 12%, around 12%, 12.2% in all mortality, and 6.6% in cardiovascular mortality. So it's in this subset of patients at high risk, it's a very good result. With the low rate of stroke, around 2.6% of stroke, 2.2% of stroke, and with a very good performance of the valve during the year, with the continuous gradient is maintained from the procedural step to the 1 year follow-up. This study is very important. It's a large study, and the result are compared with with the device, different devices like Evotar or Sapien.
So what you're saying, it was launched in 2030. So quite a few of this patient who was enrolled was the very first patient treated with the portico valve. Can you explain the portico valve and how is it designed and compared to the other valves on the market?
Well, this is a self-expandable valve. It's the first one that they have a resheatable valve. And the characteristic of this valve is a large stent cell, is an intra-annular valve, and it allows a good coronary access, is a very good conformability. So it's, for example, it's my preferred valve in very elliptic cannulus. It's a very light structure, very easy to deploy, very easy to retract, and a very good trackability because it's absolutely navigate very well in tortuosity.
So, Francesco Maisano, we heard that the outcome with the portico valve is excellent and completely comparable with the other valves on the market. Can you describe what kind of patient was actually enrolled here? Now we're talking about high risk, intermediate risk, and low risk. What was the profile of this patient in the Portico I study?
So Portico I was a registry collecting real world experience in a controlled manner, and it started in 2013. So the main indication at that time was high risk surgical patients undergoing aortic valve implantations. So today, in this sub-study, the question was, what was the risk profile of these patients and how we could characterize them a little bit better? Interestingly enough, inclusion criteria for the study was a STS score more than 8 or a high-risk surgical profile defined by the heart team. The value of Portico trial is that the reason for declaring the high risk was recorded. So we know the frailty index has been prospectively collected, and we know the comorbidities of these patients. So we went into the data and we made a sub-analysis trying to understand what are the different characteristics in this population, different level of risks, and if we wanted to see if that has a clinical impact. And we found out, first of all, interestingly, that at least two-thirds of patients had a STS score lower than 8. So the high-risk profile was defined by the heart team discussion. And this underlines once more that surgical risk scores sometimes are not catching all the high risk profile of the patients. Secondly, this study shows that in low STS score patients, you have obviously better 1 year survival comparing to the higher surgical risk patients, but also underlines that regardless of risk score, the safety profile remains the same. And this, I think, is a very important fact to underline that this valve can be adapted to different patient populations.
I fully agree. So what about the future? What's new for the Portico system? Can you shortly tell us what's in the pipeline and what can we expect in the near future?
But the valve is improving a lot in next future. We are finished the study of alternative access, but the most important evolution of this valve is the new FlexNav delivery system. The new FlexNav delivery system is as an inline sheath that this allows us to reduce the femoral, the size of a femoral access. Is very it maintains its trackability, but it increases the stability of the valve because there is a stability layer. So I implanted this new delivery system 10 times. You can appreciate immediately the stability of the device during the implantation. It is absolutely stable. You have nothing to do. It is absolutely more easy to implant. It is allowed to improve the outcomes. Probably in the next future, we'll start the study with the new valve with a skirt to reduce the perivalvular leak. In the next future, Portico I will be easier to implant and improve the result.
Thanks. So if it's just to summarize, we have heard that the Portico I valve was a study run in Europe, Canada, and Australia, including almost 1,000 patients. Early learning experience was included in the study. Despite that, we have a state-of-the-art outcome on mortality, stroke, paravalvular leak. We heard that there's something in the pipeline. We expect this year to see the alternative access approved, and also the FlexNav will come onto the market. And I can just add on here at the end that Abbott is also planning to conduct in the near future study on patients who are at increased and low surgical risk. So thank you for joining us in Paris.